Alright, so this is my first sheath that I've decided to start making. I'm going to show you the template I ended up going with. Was pretty much pretty simple. It's for the Llewellyn Bird and Trout, which is a custom-made blade, and I went ahead and customized it myself with some 550 paracord, and it came as a blank, but it was heat-treated at least, so I figured I'd use this as a nice little first attempt at a leather sheath, and went ahead and made the template. And when I finished up, I traced it on this as a way to keep it so I can put it in a folder, and then I'll be good to go with that if I ever want to make another one again. But the sheath itself, I just cut it out, and there are a few things I had to do along the lines in order to make it work. And I made the weld and already fastened it with some really good contact cement. And this contact cement is great because it has a dauber that comes in with it, a little spatula. And it's made by DAP, but it's very strong, so it'll work really well. Just want to give it time to cure. But this here is the fire steel holder here. It's just one strip. If you look at the see here, this comes out and it's folded in. Cut it to length so that it matches your weld, so that when you do put the blade in, it'll sit nice inside there. And it should work out pretty well. Gone over it a few times, but this is my first time, so I don't know when I'm making this here, if I'm gonna make any mistakes along the way that'll ruin it. So far, no. If you look at the one edge here, I disguised out a little bit of leather so that it actually fits in nice and flush. And then I put some decoration along the edge here, no big deal. And when I prepare for hand sewing, it's ready to go, and my little skull logo there on it. It should work out pretty well. I'm going to hand sew the belt loop here later, and when I do that, I'm also leaving enough room so I can put a rivet in there as well. And the rivet's going to be recessed because I'm going to skive out some of that area where that rivet's going to come through on the back side. And it's this type of blade anyway, so I'm not worried about it rubbing even if it did, but it won't rub anyway. This marking here across the leather is from, you can see it, it's from my vise where I clamped it in when I, after I put the contact cement in, I put it in the vise so it would dry, and so you're never going to see it anyway. On the back side I used some cardboard so it wouldn't mar the leather. But I made a few small mistakes, you know, I slipped here and there, it's not a big deal, but I'm going to use some Fiebing black oil dye, so the black will be really nice as well with this. And I'm thinking of making a similar sheath down the road for some Mora knives of mine. I mean, I love the Mora knife, and I like the way it fits in their sheath and everything, but I don't like the sheaths themselves. They're kind of chintzy and plastic, but this is a great way to make up for that, make your own custom leather sheath to go with it. I'm just using a wool dauber here, and I'm just going to go ahead and coat the sheath. Do a quick light coat going in circles across the front, the face of the sheath, and then I'm going to flip it around to the other side. Do a the sides here. This isn't bad for a first attempt here at making the sheath. I think I spent more time doing the template and actually messing up the template and redoing it than I did anything else. And I've learned some interesting things along the way here. I don't know why I'm even dyeing this edge, because I'm going to sand it, but it's little stuff like that, you know. And I'll show you the template I started earlier. it's totally wrong, so. And this piece here, this part of the sheath, is the part that's going to be bent over for the belt loop, so that's important to dye. I'm going to dye in a little ways here, too. I don't think I'm going to do the whole thing, though. Essentially, just go in a little ways here. Get some good coverage with your dye. Oops, see, you learn stuff like that. I just pushed too hard on that. Okay, flip out. Coverage on that, because I'm going to end up burnishing all this, and I want it to really work really well. So when I bend that over for the belt loop, it's going to need to look good, you know? So this is all going to get sanded, so I'm not worried about the edges here. I didn't get inside, see, talking about little mistakes, I didn't get inside the fire steel. I didn't dye that before I folded it over. So if you're making a really nice sheet for somebody or whatever, just keep that in mind, because if you don't do it, it's going to be a pain to try and dye. I'm going to have to get a Q-tip and get in there, but I'll be able to get in there. It'll just take a little bit. And this black dye covers really well. Whoa. I'm gonna spill that shit up. Okay, well, that's about it for that. A couple good coats on there, that's good enough. Okay, so she's dry now. Just gonna buff it. I'm using the blue shop towel. It's basically just a heavy duty paper towel. After this, all this gets done, before I sew this as well, I'm going to put some tan coat in here, and it'll make that smooth, and it'll dry out nicely, but, that's for later. All I'm doing by buffing this is getting the residue that's left over on the leather after you dye it. I'm going to apply some mink oil. put another coat of this on after I'm done as well. Just want to add a little bit to the leather. You don't want to put too much on it, but after you do, then you just let it sit for a few minutes and then go ahead and buff it off, and then buff whatever, you know, is on there off. Allow this to soak in. What I like to do is take it over and either place it in the oven at a real low heat temperature, or I have a little portable heater. I set it in front of that for a few minutes and let it soak in a bit. And just wipe it off there. I've worked with leather in the past, but I've never really gone into crafting a lot, you know. Always repairing stuff that I had or just making little things. But never like a knife sheath. This is actually the first knife sheath from veg that I ever made. I just cut it out. And it's actually pretty fun. I used tandy leather to get some supplies, but I also ordered from a different vendor, Zach White. I'm gonna show you some stuff I got from them, some of the tools that you need for leather crafting, and I'm not going to go into that in this video, but there's all kinds of leather crafting videos you can find online. I think Ian Atkinson, I think his name is, I'll link his videos down below. He's from the UK. He's really good with leather and far better than I am, and so just by watching some of his videos, I picked up on some of the things that I can do to make my own sheets. This is a burnishing tool, and you can use it for wet forming, and it was only like $4, I think, and it's not bone, but it looks like bone. It's a hard plastic, very smooth, rounded edges. And it helps you to burnish really well, and if you have a tight area to get into, this helps do that, or this can get in there as well. So, and you know, like a cork back metal ruler, this was only a couple of dollars, I think, but I never owned one before, so it's my first. And the wool daubers are pretty cheap as well. They're only a couple dollars for, I think, 10. So you get a few of those, and you can use the same one several times without worrying about it drying up on you too much. I take my towel and I squeeze it after I'm done using it to get the excess out, and then hang dry it. But from Zach White Leather, I ordered my dyes, and I only used the professional oil dye, which is highly recommended, and I know why. It's because it's such high quality. It really gives you a nice finish on your leather products. And it doesn't like smear off and give you a patchy type of dye on your leather. It's really, really nice. It seeps in. And it dies pretty deep and even as well. But I ordered for $15. I ordered a big batch of just veg tan leather scraps, and surprisingly, a few pieces came out really nice. I mean, this is how it came cut, and this is about an 8 or 9, maybe an 8 weight. And it's pretty nice though, and it's pretty even, except for this little piece right here is kind of thin, but the rest of it's really even, and I can definitely get a really nice holster or two out of this. There are several pieces and straps that come with it. And then you can order the full leather, like, I don't have enough room to fit this in there, but this is the whole shoulder here. Or, sorry, this is the whole belly. And so, this is really nice leather as well. And the belly only ran me about $24, something like that. The scraps, it's a several pound bag of scraps, which ran me, I think, $13 or $14. So that'll get you started, and it's good to practice. Like, I practiced quite a bit when I first got this stuff. That way you're not ruining your good veg leather. That would suck. But yeah. Okay, so I went ahead and sewed up the belt loop here, and I put a couple of rivets in it, and closed it up, cemented up the edges with the contact cement, and just did that a minute ago, made sure it was lined up properly, sealed it up, tapped it with my hammer, and pinned it right here in my guide hole, which is my top hole right here, the first one. So, just place my punch through right there, and it's just holding it there. This contact cement is great. I mean, I don't even need to clamp it. I'm just going to hold it for a few minutes like this, and then when it's done, just let it sit for about an hour, and then I'll go ahead and start getting ready to sew it up. I place the knife in it, and it sits in there nicely. Nice friction fit, and it fits real nice. There's no way that's falling out. Now, I decided to wrap my knife with the paracord because I figured in the field I can take this off, and all I have to do is pull this out, and I have a bunch of 550. And as long as I wrap it close to the same, it'll get the same fit in the sheath. Plus, if I ever decide to make a handle for it, the handle is, I can make it pretty close to what that is, and it'll fit the same anyway. But again, this is my first sheath, so it's not like the most important thing. I decided to use this knife for that reason. Now, the sheath is definitely not void of its mistakes. There's a couple of small mistakes that I made. But I mean, after I sand this edge and get this edge cleaned up really nice and stain it, I'm gonna go through and make sure everything's lined up nice and everything. The one thing I'd change though is the belt loop, maybe just shift it to the right just a hair. I mean, it's straight and everything, it's straight in line with the knife, but if you look at it, it's just a little bit out. A little too far out on that way, but you can't really even tell. And I checked it with my 2.5 or 2.75 inch belt, and it slips in there nice and snug, so it'll fit my combat type belt no problem. And the main thing here is to have a good learning experience on making a sheath, you know. It's not about making a super high-grade type sheath, but it's not bad overall. Next, I'll be making a sheath for my Mora. See if I can get that out here for you. Because you know how they come with the plastic sheaths and everything. And really nice sheaths. But I'd like to make a little black leather sheath very similar to this for my Mora, and I think I'll be using the pattern that I made for this, only I think I'll adjust it a little bit for design. I think I'm going to make it so that the top side of the sheath is a little different, and I want the back side of the sheath to come all the way up so I can have a snap fastener around the handle, but most of it's going to be about the same. Now on this, when I did the weld, I ended up taking a little bit more off the weld, so might have to adjust this one final time before I use it as my template. But as you can see, this Mora knife actually comes very close to fitting perfectly in this exact same sheath. I'd make the weld a little different so it fits a little different inside there, because as you can see, the knife hooks a little bit more on the top here, but it should work. So I'll let that dry and go ahead and get ready to sew it up. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to thread a needle for leather sewing real fast here. I have this one side done already, so I'll go ahead and do the other one. And you just want to flatten your the edge of your thread and pass it through the eye of the needle, like so. And pull it through a little ways, and kind of at the head of your, you're going to stab it, alright? What you're trying to do is split it. It helps to pull it up then. Let me try that again. Okay, so I stab through the middle. Right? And it's a simple thing, really. You just pull down, focus down towards the end. Pull your loop through till you just got a little bit of loop left. Okay? And then just pull this thread over. Just like that. Okay. Pull on the string till it comes down tight on your needle. And you're good to go. You're ready to go ahead and start sewing. And since you did that to both sides, you're set. Of course, you're going to need a lot more thread. You measure your thread properly. You just hold the thread up to the one side of wherever you're going to start sewing. Hold the thread to the other side wherever you're going to end up finishing sewing, from one side to the other, in other words. And then measure that times, I'd say six times, something like that. It's give and take, and I'm not an expert, I don't know. But it's better to have more thread than what you need than not enough. So, because if you think about it, what you're doing when you do the saddle stitch, you're going in the hole this way, and then in the hole this way, in the same hole, and you're just pulling tight. And you're doing it all over again, back and forth through that same hole. Through each hole. And so, you're not using a ton of thread, but you're using twice the amount you normally would be if you're just using one needle and going through a hole. So, keep that in mind. And then I'm just going to have to learn as I go, too, you know. Just figure out how much I need with every run, and sew away. Sorry, I almost forgot where I was there for a minute there. I forgot to turn the camera on. But I've gone ahead and I drilled all the holes. And I'm just going to go ahead and do the little touch-ups here for what I did here. I screwed up here and slipped, but that's how it goes until you get used to this kind of thing, you know. But I think I'll be able to fix it just fine. And I'm just doing a little touch up here with the oil dye. And then I'm going to go ahead and use my dauber and touch this up. But first I'm going to go ahead and shave this down a little bit. Okay, so it's nice and smooth, and then we'll sew it up, and that'll be it. Okay, so I started sewing it already, and got most of it done. What I did was, I started in the third hole down, and I just went in with my thread on each end, evened out the strings so that my needles were even, and then I went up and up. So I just sewed up those two holes, and then sewed all the way back down. I'll show you how that's done here. Since I'm almost done, it doesn't hurt to show you how I'm doing this. So I have the threads even. Give it a good tug after each time you go through a hole. I'm going to stick it through the hole, and pull it all the way through. Grab the other needle, and go through the hole I just went through. So essentially I'm just crisscrossing the needles. So give it a good tug, on to the next hole. Tug. Tug. Now, just like up top, down here at the end is going to get a little bit difficult because I'll be sewing backwards through the holes. And the needles are going to be a bit tight. But it's okay. Okay, so that's the last hole. Now I'm going to sew back down two more holes and tie it off here in the corner. So. And it didn't take me too long to do this, so. Say about 10 minutes or so. That fires out for that. Some strong thread, man. It's waxed, so it's extra strong. It's gonna grip. That's beautiful. Now all I'm gonna do is come through this next hole only one way with this one. So both my needles are on the same side of the sheath. Alright. So now this is what you've got. So I'm going to take this and tie it into a knot. Some people do it differently. Some people can let the thread go back in, push it down in, and everyone has their own way of doing it. So I'm going to tie that off into a knot and pull it really tight. Let me go through the hole if I can here. Get rid of that needle by pulling it all the way through the nearest hole, right? Same with this one, but this one's going to go through the other side of the hole here. Hope I'm not confusing you here. I'll show you why I did that. So essentially, remember my thread was out of these two holes here, coming up this way. All I did was tie a knot, put them back through the other side, so that that knot is here. And now my thread's on this side, and I'm going to cut that off real close, and then kind of like heat up the edges so they melt a little bit and push them down in. So it looks just like a normal stitch, but it has the extra strength of a knot on one side, and these aren't going anywhere. So I'm going to cut them off flush. I'm going to take my lighter, and I'm going to just very lightly with each one of these so they melt down in, and poke them on through with my my Jabba Polka, and that's about it for that. Then the next step is burnishing. Okay, for burnishing, you want to get your tools out of the way. And get the water out, the sponge. Use this side here. You can use whatever sponge you want. I just happen to have an extra natural sponge laying around, so I'm not going to use this for painting. So what you're going to do is just going to wet the edge slightly. Get your burnish. Get your burnishing tool out. And you're going to rub. Naturally, if there was just one piece of leather, I'd use this side, but you can't use this, so I'm going to use the flat edge of this. And all I'm doing is rotating my sheath as I'm giving it some good force here. It's going to take a little bit to get that to heat up a bit to really get it to set. You have to apply some pressure when you do this, so don't be too timid. But you're rolling the sheath because you want that nice rounded edge. As you can see, it's already starting to burnish here compared to up here. This is already getting shiny. All right, and I apologize if the if the lighting isn't the best in here right now. This is all you're going to do across the entire edge. Give this sheath a nice protected edge, nice and burnished. Do this as well. I'm going to take my knife out. I'm going to burnish all the edges that I didn't do yet. I'm going to be good to go.